this tutorial I decided to build something nice, and one of comments I received below my videos was about customizing top navigation menu and adding some images. I thought it would be a good idea to create another series dedicated to top navigation on how we can build a Magento 2 extension which follows best practices, and it's not going to be a mega super duper luxury menu extension with lots of JavaScript, lots of PHTML code, and it would be elegant, nice and crisp extension so you can use. However, in this video I decided to show you how we can customize a label for a top navigation menu and make it look nicer. Hello, you wonderful people. My name is Max Pronko and I'm a Magento YouTuber. I create various videos about Magento 2 best practices on how to work and build custom themes, custom extensions, third-party integrations, and how you can follow best practices in order to build your next Magento 2 extension. Smash this subscribe button if you like my videos, and don't forget to hit like and comment below this video, so I would be more than happy to answer. As you can see, I have a nice label for the top navigation. This label is new, and in this video I would like to show you how I styled this label and what tools I used. I want to say that I didn't customize a menu behavior. I just went ahead and simulated this kind of custom menu, because currently there is no out-of-box way on how you can add additional labels for the menu, because this is a part of category top navigation rendering, and if you would like to add programmatically new label into your top navigation menu, you would have to use one of approaches. First of all, you can create a custom attribute, category attribute, and make sure it's rendered as part of top navigation. Or you can use observer, top menu observer, and add custom HTML content, or you can build your own menu. So I decided to go yet another approach, or to try another approach, and just insert my desired HTML content, which is label, and style it accordingly. My HTML part, which I added, is span. It's additional DOM element I introduced for one of menu items, and this is under li. I decided to put it before a, because if I would put it into a tag, when I hover on the menu, this will also highlight my label. So it's not a correct behavior, and you would need to add more CSS styles in order to dismiss hovering of this, or changing colors or background of your label. So it's a good practice, from my opinion, to put this label before actual link. And once you have this link, you can go into your custom theme. In my case, I went to webcss_source_extended_less, and in less for desktop media query. And if you aren't familiar with media queries, I created two videos on how to work with media queries and what is media query and how to build or how to add custom media queries, how to extend it, and how to use it in your less file. So under desktop media query, I added under navigation CSS class, I added new. This is a CSS class I have under span, for span, and I added styles for this span. Couple of important things. First of all, color is different. Position has to be absolute. And then with the help of top and right, you can position this span in a way and in a position where you would like to see it in your custom sim. So in my case, it's top minus 8 and right minus 5. With some padding, I also think that TextTransform uppercase would work best for my sim. And as a result, I see this nice label, greenish green label. I also added after in order to introduce this small little thing. If we will open inspect, and as you can see, it adds and removes this arrow. This arrow is very nice and very helpful for users when they will come and will see this navigation with your label. They wouldn't think twice about this new label, whether you have new extensions or you have new services. So it's clearly says that in this sim I have new Magento 2 extensions. So user will likely click this menu item and will see new extensions. And this is it. So if you would like to follow this approach, you have to add two things. First one is a new CSS class and style it, style your span HTML. And then you can add after to introduce this nice little arrow. If you would like to customize in a way you think is the best one, top menu, you can open first of all a template from module sim view frontend templates html top menu.html file, and there is a menu variable, and you can control click in PHP Storm this get.html, and you will get this to this top menu.php where you can find a name of a event name, and you can create your own observer in order to customize a menu before it will actually be rendered on a page. Also, you can use get HTML after, but it's kind of, I recommend you to use before. So you can use actually observer or, yeah, observer. In other scenarios, you would be willing to create your custom navigation. And important to say is that in Magento 2.3, there is a pull request on improving out-of-box top menu class in order for us developers easily introduce new menu items. So instead of building whole navigation, you can use that extension point in order to add your custom menu items. This is it for today's tutorial. I hope you liked it and hit subscribe button. I would be more than happy to see your name and your comments below the video, and I will see you tomorrow for the next tutorial.